Hey everybody, welcome back. In this lesson, we're talking about a characteristic of the X-ray beam called beam quantity. The word quantity refers to the number of something, how much or how many there is of something. For example, in this image, the quantity of eggs is about 11. Quantity is only the number, not the type or the size or the color or the quality. It's just the number. This is true of eggs, and it's also true of the X-ray beam. So concerning the X-ray beam, quantity refers to the number of X-ray photons. In this illustration of the X-ray beam, different energies are represented by different colors, but the quantity refers only to the total number, not the energy. When we're referring to the X-ray beam, a synonym for quantity is the word intensity. Quantity and intensity refer strictly to the total amount of X-ray photons in the beam, not the energy or anything else. It's just the number. When discussing the X-ray beam quantity or intensity, we use specific measurements. Quantity is measured as exposure in units of coulombs per kilogram, or we can measure the quantity, that's the intensity, as air kerma in units of gray. These measurements basically tell us how much radiation there is in air. The X-ray beam quantity is influenced by several factors, including the milliamperage, that's the MA, exposure time, KVP, distance, specifically that's the distance from the radiation source to the point of measurement, and the filtration. Changes to these variables have very predictable and measurable effects on the quantity or intensity of the X-ray beam. Let's start by talking about the milliamperage. Remember that MA is simply the tube current. That's the rate of electron flow through the X-ray tube. In a river, a small current is a small amount of water flow, and a large current is a large amount of water flow. In an X-ray tube, we have something very similar going on. A small current, or small MA, results in a low quantity. That's a fewer number of X-ray photons. But a large current, that's a large MA, results in a high number of X-ray photons, which we could describe as high quantity or high intensity. So here's the relationship we need to understand. Increasing the MA, which is the tube current, increases the beam quantity, also known as the intensity. Of course, the reverse is also true. If we decrease the MA, this results in a decreased beam quantity or decreased intensity. This relationship assumes that only the MA is changing and all other factors remain the same. Another factor affecting beam quantity or intensity is the exposure time. Exposure time simply refers to the total amount of time that electrons are flowing in the tube and X-rays are being created. The longer the tube stays on, the more total X-rays are produced. And like the MA, exposure time plays a major role in controlling the total number of photons. So here's the relationship we should understand. As we increase the exposure time, this increases the quantity or total intensity of the X-ray beam. If we decrease the exposure time, this results in decreased beam quantity or decreased beam intensity. The next variable that influences beam quantity is the kilovoltage peak, or KVP. KVP refers to the voltage between the cathode and anode within the X-ray tube. Some people think that KVP only affects the X-ray beam energy or quality, but that's actually not true at all. KVP has an enormous effect on the beam intensity. A low KVP results in low quantity or low intensity in the X-ray beam. But a high KVP results in a high X-ray beam quantity or high intensity. And unlike MA and time, KVP affects both the quantity and the quality of the X-ray beam. Notice in this image that when we use a high KVP, there are more total photons, but we can also see higher energy photons. In this illustration, the low energy photons are represented by orange and yellow, but high energy photons are represented as red. So here's the relationships that we should understand about KVP. When we increase the KVP, this increases the quantity. That's the total number of X-ray photons. But don't forget, it also increases the quality or energy of the X-ray beam. But if we decrease the kVp, this results in a decrease in the quantity, so there's fewer total photons. But it also results in a decrease in the quality or energy of those photons. Let's look at a quick question to check our understanding. The quantity is also known as which of these answer options? The correct answer is beam intensity. Remember that quantity strictly refers to the total number of X-rays in the X-ray beam. Another word for quantity is intensity. In summary, beam quantity refers to the total number of photons in an X-ray beam. You should know that beam quantity is also known as beam intensity, and it is determined by several factors, including the three discussed in this lesson: MA, exposure time, and kVp. We'll discuss the other factors in another lesson. It's important to remember that the relationship is such that as we increase any of these factors, MA, exposure time, or kVp, we increase the beam quantity or intensity. Increased MA, longer exposure times, and higher kVp all add to the quantity of photons in the X-ray beam and therefore increase the beam intensity. If you enjoyed this video, I encourage you to visit cloverlearning.com and explore our robust selection of video-based courses, certification exam prep question banks, and continuing education resources. Lastly, please remember to hit the like button, subscribe, and turn on notifications so you can stay up to date on our latest videos.